is the same, which bonds them together, which gives you better traction. Then we back up in our tracks, we come back up and we stage, both cars get ready, and then we put out the staging lights, and you wait for your light to come on, and as soon as you see the light, then it's reaction time, and you go, and I run at about 300 or 400 feet, and I shift the car, and at the first light down there, which is the top speed light, I pull a parachute there, so the car drives away from the pilot chute. You go through the lights, then you let off the throttle, push the fuel shut off, turn the engine off, and if everything goes like it's supposed to, you have no problem.
Tower 5 will be on. And now, the snake. Running to him, Connie Coletta, in his rifle powered Logie chassis, Mustang body car.
Heat blast motor and six elephant motor.
I'm very uptight, but the whole time when I get to the races, the time I pull into the gate, I get very, very uptight. I'm nervous. I'm scared to death always of getting beat. And I don't care who I'm racing, whether it's McEwen or anyone else. I just don't eat or nothing. It's a great deal of concentration on the lights and when to shift the car. The car has a two-speed transmission in it, how to shift it at the right time so you don't start the tire smoking. If you overwind, it'll start the tire smoking. There's a great deal in concentration and getting down towards the finish light. When you see the first light come up, you know, three lights down there, as the first one comes up, you have to get ready for the shoot and hit it at the right time so it blossoms, stops the car, and get the car to a safe stop.
What's happening is, so far, we've beaten Prudhomme and the Super Duster. Prudhomme has beaten Coletta. Coletta has beaten the Super Duster. So, this round, if I beat Coletta, then we win. Coletta beats me, then that means he only has been beat one time. If Prudhomme wins this time, he'll just have been beaten once. So that could make, if I lose and Prudhomme and Coletta both win, then it will be a three-way tie for first. But don't worry about that happening. I'll see that don't happen. That's too confusing for everybody. We'll get a headache thinking about it.
Don?
Yeah?
You made your second run of the day. How's the car running now that you've made the adjustment?
It's running better. It's still not right. It's still wanting to smoke the tires off the start line, which you lose, you know, a great deal of elapsed time, which is, of course, wins the race. And it should run a little better next time. I lost my brakes down there that time, though. I got to figure out what that is or what's happening or whatever. I hope I didn't puncture a brake line. If it wasn't for this parachute, I'd have been in serious trouble.
After making that first run and going up in smoke, as I was listening to the engine, I knew what I had to do for the next round, even before I took my foot out of it. It's just one of those things that comes to you. It's just like reading music. I guess you know, if, you know, when you're playing an instrument, if you hit a bad note, you know why or something. Well, it's the same way with the race car when it's in smoke. We took counterweight off the clutch. We pulled the spark advance back in the engine to kill the low-end horsepower. We put a different compound of tires on the car, made a little bit of fuel adjustment. Made a jet change in the engine, all this in one run. A lot of guys wouldn't do that. They just change the tires. And, well, let's try that again. But you can't do that because I was off so far, I just couldn't come back and drop a tenth. I had to drop a whole bunch, close to a second.
What do you got up your sleeve?
free this time.
I'm gonna blow your drawers off. That's all
right. How can you do that to me? I'm a guest. I'm a visitor. You live here. Be nice.
Hey, I know. It's just the same treatment I get when I come to California.
Why?
Dill, instant dill, right? Powder. Come on, Pink, put more in it.
You got a pink oil filter and everything on here. I mean, that's it, right? You make a long one and a short one, right?
Yeah, that'd be close enough.
Okay, us too.
Right.
We'll do the same.
Okay.
Try to be ready, okay?
Yeah.
When I woke this morning, something inside of me told me this would be my day. I heard the morning train, I felt the wind change. Too many times I'm on my way. Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? The wind can shake me, brothers forsake me. The rain can touch me, can I touch the rain? And then I saw the sunrise above a cotton sky, like a candy, candy light. I saw the milkman, I saw the businessman, I saw the only road in sight. Then I got to thinking.
During the afternoon, the Snake and Mongoose match racing has taken in the local funny car competition also. Tom McEwen won the meet, and Don Prudhomme set a new track record. It looks pretty easy, but listening to Don and Tom tell about it, it's a long road to get to the top.
You don't necessarily have to come out and jump right in the AA classes right off. Work yourself up to it. You don't have to come out and race for the money. People can come out and run for the trophies and have a good time and bring the family out and just go out and do it. They've got tracks all over the United States, 200 or 300 of them now. They even run on Wednesdays and Friday nights for grudge racing. There's no reason for kids to street race anymore.
That's not so much the way anymore. The kid takes his mom's car out to the races. It used to be that way when money was tighter and so on. When I was coming up, that was kind of the way it was. You'd borrow the family car and take it to the drag races. It's changed a great deal. Kids nowadays seem to have more money and they have their own cars at the drag races by the time they're old enough to drive.
We have done stuff that engineers in Detroit told us wouldn't work. And now they just shake their heads, and now they've incorporated a lot of that stuff into the new cars. So you've really got to get everything together, you know, because it's a far out thing, you know, and it's, you'd have to come out and see it to appreciate it. You know, it's not a kid's thing, and yet it is.
It's a whole way of life for Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen. It's moving down the road, town after town, state after state, making life good. Getting it on to the next match race. Match Race, one of a series of racing specials, has been brought to you by the people in your town who bottle Coca-Cola. It's the real thing, Coke.